Hello, and welcome to the Paint Gun Testing Initiative. You have been in hibernation for...
9999999.
That doesn't seem right. Well, it doesn't really matter. Please leave the restroom whenever you are ready. I know that bed might look comfy... but we've got much to do, so please exit your room. You know, I don't even know why they even bother giving you a bed. They will drag the test subjects into the stasis chambers anyways. After long periods of hibernation, the human body loses some of its strength. So, before we get to the paint gun testing, we should do some warm-up testing. Don't worry, nothing too difficult. Testing hasn't officially begun yet, so we're free to talk without anyone listening in on us. But your profile says you're not an early bird, so I understand if you don't want to talk at the moment. I was just informed that even if we are not testing yet, I am not allowed to mention anything that is mentioned in your profile. That is my profile. I know this experiment will go without any problems. I can see it in you. Pick up the device and let the vacuum delivery system take us to the first test involving paint. Okay, I know you're wondering what you are holding. Don't worry, it'll all make sense as we progress. Let me see... there. Okay, just go through the door now. Alright, why don't you try firing your gun? See what happens. You solved that really fast. Now, this next chamber should offer more of a challenge for us. Very good. Nice. Okay, maybe it's time to introduce myself. I'm Nigel, and I will be your testing associate for this testing track. Glad to meet you. Test subject name here. Guess you forgot to fill that in. Don't worry, I'll get that checked. In case you haven't noticed yet, that green field, the Aperture Science Paint Gun Activation Field, also known as Fizzler, will activate and deactivate your paint gun. guess that painting is all good and fun, but cleaning that stuff up is horribly expensive. So just please only spray where you think is necessary. Our Aperture Science sentient washing servos will thank you. Now this is the Advanced Jumping Training Course. It will teach you, ideally, how to navigate through future test chambers. Jump. Looks really fun. Sometimes I wish I had legs so I could do what you do, but then I remember the other things we do to test subjects. I probably shouldn't have said that. Don't worry, I'm sure you'll be fine. Look at this! I just looked at the documentation for these big monitors. Let me show you myself. Sweet, isn't it? Now you can look at me! So it's not as creepy knowing you're being watched, cause you can watch me too! How cool is that? Oh, the door! Let me get that for you. And the song! Good luck! You seem to be getting the hang of this. See you on the other side. Although I can see you all the time, you're in a ventilatory dispatch system. Now this is where the fun begins. A real puzzle. You will have to use all the skills you've learned in the previous chambers. Let me put some ambient music on to get us in a good puzzle-solving mood. Good luck.
Hey, where are you?
I can't
see you. Did you find anything interesting? Just be sure to go back into the testing chamber when you are done with your, business. Ew, I forgot humans needed to leak. I don't think it's true. There's a goo at the bottom of the test chamber. Disgusting. Exit the room. Chop chop, you should be able to reach the exit rather quickly. Turns out that the vacuum tube I gave you for the previous test does not connect to the next test chamber. So we are going to have to walk for a little bit. This elevator is malfunctioning, so we will have to turn around and see if we can find somewhere else where we can continue our tests. This test chamber was for another test, which we are not assigned to. It was supposed to be solved with a portal gun. Wicked stuff. I'm sure there's a way we can solve it in our way. Done! I couldn't have done it better myself. Now, we have to find a vacuum delivery system to get you. This elevator is broken too, I think. We are looking for a vacuum delivery system. The door is rigged to open when the subject walks through the corridor. I should have probably prevented that from happening. Just jumping in and we'll be on our way. Now, this test does make use of portals as a testing element. If you've never bumped into them before, they're pretty straightforward. Thingy goes in, thingy goes out. Are a piece of cake. Nothing out of this world. It's time to increase the complexity just by one variable. Great! Now use your gel gun to actually get to the testing site out there in the gorge. Careful now, that thing crushes you to death. Its official name is the Aperture Science Cold Work Apparatus. We should simply call it the Crusher. Easy to remember. Phew, nicely done. You know, we actually have one guy whose only job is to name all the Aperture Science patented devices. He even came up with that term. Just a standard testing sphere, nothing special. The average human doesn't have the reaction times required for this test, so I will shout out the directions you gotta go. This really helps out with survival rates. In theory, we're the first ones here, ready when you are. Left turn! 180, right turn! Right turn coming up! Impossible jump ahead! We did a really good job out there. You flying around all over the place and I tell you how to get there. I should get the guys up here to do more tests like this. Now that we have boat gels at our disposal, we want to be more careful about our next move. We don't want to end up short or overdo a jump. Noticed, but we are now on the upper levels of Aperture Science. No more recycling tests. It's all brand new from now on. Sorry, but this test did not have a connected vacuum delivery system. I want to remind you that these tests are still in an alpha state. This chamber can be quite hard to nail down on the first try, so I drained out the goo. So don't be afraid if you fall down. Use the stairs to get back up.
Okay, now we just have to find a way into the entrance of the test. What did you do? What was that noise? Know what that noise was. That's one mystery solved. Unfortunately, I cannot drain that goo. So, change of plans. Be careful. Thanks, science! I thought our testing spree has come to an end. Proceed to the next chamber! Introduction to Fizzler. This one should be pretty easy. And the song. What? What is this? No. How do I get rid of it? Okay, login. User control. Subject FBWB. Audio controls. Password? Hello, password. Let's try password 1. No. Password 2. No. Oh wait, I got it. I think I got it. And there. So sorry about that. I don't even know how that got there. I mean, why do they even have this kind of music in the music library? Unless it was part of the test and I screwed it up. Well, if it was, the damage is done now. Just test. Oh, Jesus. This might have been your best performance yet. Unfortunately, the metal music was part of the test. So this test does not count towards your performance. Sorry! Advanced Flow Mechanics. While there is no time limit to this test, it is encouraged that we make an effort to be quick. You never know when it can be useful to be fast. Not perfect, but we still have plenty of time to work on your issues. Remember that time I said we were not going to recycle old test chambers? It turns out I was wrong. Have fun. Thank you. Just because it's not an original test, it does not mean it isn't valuable. Proceed to the exit. Don't worry, I stopped the door to the elevator from opening automatically. Just look out for our vacuum tube. Does make use of portals as a testing element. If you've never bumped into them before, they're pretty straightforward. Thingy goes in, thingy goes out. Strange sense of deja vu. If you ever forget why we do this, it's because of science. But more importantly, for the future. Because testing is the future, and the future starts with us. But more importantly, science. Good luck. Final chamber! If you solve this test, it means you are eligible to perform a series of highly dangerous procedures, and that was what we were testing for. Another mystery solved. For you, I knew from the very beginning. And now to save the world of Aperture Science! As I said,
you made it through the experiment, but if you want to survive, you have to listen to me and do what I say. First thing, jump over that gap. Now go through the door that says authorized personnel only. Don't worry, you're authorized personnel now. That, my friend, is what keeps this whole place alive and running and working. It's the Aperture Laboratory Stability Stable Energy Reactor, or the ULSR. What? What? No! These names are ridiculous sometimes. I will call it what I want. We will discuss this later. I am in the middle of an experiment. I'm sorry, I've got to fix something. Just get to the control panel on the bottom floor. I will catch you later. Sorry about the interruption. Aperture Science is now upgraded to a new ULSR, which means this one has to be shut down as it's useless. However, this process is quite dangerous and has to be done manually. There are two buttons. Go ahead and press one. As long as you press one, you should be fine. No! I mean the other one! If you cannot follow simple instructions, then we do not have a chance at succeeding. You're lucky this was not a critical step. After you catch your breath, go ahead and press the first button labeled as 1. If you stop for even a second, you are a dead test subject. No time to lose. Go! Terrific navigational skills there! This has been a very successful experiment, so far. I have very high expectations for you. You are definitely the best of the best.
You should have noticed that the flow direction on the green fizzlers matter. If you did not notice that, please fill out the appropriate submission forms at the end of the test. I know what you must be wondering. What are we testing for? How is this going to end? Where else has Nigel lied to me? When did I learn his name was Nigel? Why does it look like I'm outside? Where is he getting with all these questions? I mentioned my name somewhere before. Don't worry though. Those other answers will all be answered later on. It's not like we will end the test abruptly. We have more than enough funding. Thanks, Atranium. Okay, so we need some questions to push our testing forward. Give you a reason to keep you engaged with the test. How do we know you are not going to idle for an hour before you solve this test chamber? See? Even I have questions that need some answering. Maybe not an hour, but you still idle for quite a while, just doing nothing, supposedly thinking how to solve the test. Oh yeah, you did a terrific job! Keep it up! This test chamber is divided in two parts, one where you get the three cubes and another when you get to the exit. Good luck! job, young lad. Your papa and mama should be proud. Who designed this testing protocol? Sometimes I feel like they just make this stuff up as they go along. Now this test chamber is located in a real desert. Don't worry, you'll obtain a complimentary Citranium can at the end of the test. I know I will. Citranium, it's science in a can. Just head over to the vending machine and... well, it seems that we've run out of Citranium cans at the moment. Don't panic though, I will personally see that you get your Citranium can at the end of the test. Do you feel angry at the end of a test chamber? Or alone? Or depressed? The new Aperture Science Exotic Location staging will eliminate all of those feelings by simulating the authentic outsides that the humans were born to roam. If you think that you still experience the negative emotion while testing, fill out the appropriate submission form at the end of the test. A not-so-fun fact, the water in this test is recycled from the old test chambers we were solving a couple hours ago. I would still enjoy the mist. Our Aperture Science water filter and cleaning systems destroy 99.3% of human waste. So if you took a toilet break early on, don't worry. There is practically none of your urine in the air. flying there. If my calculations are right, you came into contact with 0.21 milliliters of your own pee. See? It's insignificant. Great scientific progress is what we do here. This chamber only uses the blue gel, but don't let that get to you. This is one of our toughest puzzles. Whoever designed this has evil intentions and no mercy at all. But I am sure you will do just fine. This aperture science exotic location station was so calm and peaceful. I hope it helped you with your thinking. Also, I'm not allowed to transform the aperture science official nomenclatures into acronyms now, so we'll just have to live with it. Although it will not be long for you. Because we are near the end of the test, of course. This is it! The last puzzle chamber! The final picture! The maybe not so grand finale! Is it that so many structures are extremely fragile? I'm guessing someone from civil engineering is gonna get sacked soon. Science, you have the bladder of a pregnant woman. Go do your business and get back to the testing as soon as you are done. Again? You did your business not so long ago. Why do you even bother with exploring your surroundings? It's not like you're going to encounter a life-changing moment. that you got that out of the way, we can go back and finish the test chamber. We are almost near the end of the test chamber now. Do not let me down. Fits those of a previous test subject. She almost blew up the whole facility and killed my boss once. So I have instructions to let you go to avoid any future problems. Go through the door. This elevator will take you to the surface. We won't meet again. This is it. Goodbye. You know, you were my first test subject. You will always have a deep place inside my gears. Farewell, my human test subject.